Hello everyone. There are various modes of sexual reproduction in case of fungi. The first type is planogametic copulation. In this, the motile flagellated gametes are called planogametes, and the mode of fusing is as such that one of the gamete is either movable or motile, whereas another one is not motile. In some other cases, both of them will be motile but will be of two different shape and size. Whereas in the third category, both of them will be similar in shape and size and motility as well. So the first category is isogamy, where we see that both the gametes are of same shape and size and are motile. When they both fuse, they form a nucleus, and that nucleus is a diploid zygote. In anisogamy, one of the gamete is of larger size, which is a female gamete, whereas the male gamete is smaller in size, and it is known as anisogamy because there is structural difference in case of both the gametes. Oogamy is the third category, which is quite similar to the ones to the higher organisms like the human beings, where the male gamete is motile and is smaller in size, whereas the female gamete is non-motile and is larger in size. When the fusion occurs, it results in formation of zygote. Now, the example is Allomyces or Syncytrium. So you should remember both the examples. Gametangel contact is second kind of sexual reproduction in the fungi, where the male gametangium sends a tubular outgrowth outwards its fertilization tube or fertilization area. And from this, it can move and form or send its nucleus to the female gametangium. So you can see the antheridium, which is dark blue colored, and this is the male gamete, whereas the female gamete is this one. Now the antheridium is sending a pore. This tube is the protuberance which is formed by the male gametangium, and it is, as because it is sending a tube, it is releasing its nuclear content inside the oogonia or the female gametangium, leading to the fertilization. And this is seen in albugo or phytophthora. Gametangel copulation is the third category of sexual reproduction, where two different strains of fungi, they fuse together or come in sexual contact with each other to form a zygospore, and that zygospore is diploid, giving rise to the next plant body. It is rhizopus or mucor. These are the examples for it. You can see the gametangia, both the strains are different. One is positive strain, other one is negative strain. The male gametangium as well as the female gametangium both develop on the same host, but there is just connection formed in between both of them in order to or it just looks like two dumbbells coming in close proximity and then after forming a axis together or just fusing the inner membrane. Spermatization is the third technique of sexual reproduction, in which uninucleate spore like body called spermatia are formed. This is a spore, uninucleated spore like body. See, in this structure a trichogyne is formed or a receptive hypha is there. Because of the presence of receptive hypha, trichogyne means it is a female structure, and this female structure is receptive of the male spermatid and or spermatia, and as a result the spermatium is transferred into the receptive hypha through this microconidia, and as a result we get the developed plant body, which is seen in either in Puccinia or Neurospora. So you just look at the structure and try to understand that there is the female body or the hypha receives the male microconidia, and from the microconidia the nucleus is transferred inside the gametangium, as because the trichogyne is receptive in the sense it is capable of taking the nucleus within itself, resulting in formation of archiocarp or the entire plant body. Somatogamy is the last category of sexual reproduction where the sex organs are not formed. Just two vegetative or somatic cells are there, and they are present together in dikaryotization stage, just as in agaricus. So you can see that two different strains are there. The globular, this one is suppose a positive strain. The dotted one is a negative strain. Both of the strains, they are present together, and just they are, since they are present together, they look as dikaryon, or this is a dikaryon stage which is present. So this can be seen in agaricus, which is a deuteromycete or the most developed fungi.